I just appeared. What am I supposed to do about that? Ugh. All right, let's try this again. Ugh, not again. This game stinks! Ugh. No matter what I do, I can't get past this darn intersection. I crash every single time. Why? I need to figure out a fix for this game so I can survive this intersection and make it to the finish line. Wanna help me? Let's go! In the real world, driving a car, truck, or even bike means following road instructions provided by signs and signals to prevent traffic jams and car accidents. I'm excited to introduce all of you to Erin, a civil engineer at Olsson. Olsson is a large engineering firm that does projects from coast to coast and employs more than 2,000 people. In Kansas, Olsson has offices in Overland Park, Olathe, and Manhattan. Erin works out of their Overland Park office but serves clients in several states. Hi Erin, thank you for meeting with us today.
You're welcome, we're gonna learn a lot together.
That's great, because I'm curious what engineers do exactly. Can you explain it for me?
Sure. Engineers use their deep understanding of science and mathematics to analyze, design, invent, code, and create solutions to real-world problems. We create things like roads, skyscrapers, robots, and tools. If you've ever played Minecraft or built something out of Legos, you've done some engineering.
Okay, I've definitely done both of those things before. I think she's just the person to solve my problem.
There are many types of engineers who use scientific principles to solve problems. Engineers design everything from computers to chemicals to spaceships. I'm a civil engineer, which means I'm focused on solving problems to help communities run smoothly. If you have traveled on the interstate, flushed a toilet, or gotten a green light at a traffic signal, you can thank a civil engineer.
I had no idea there were that many kinds of engineers.
I know, right? Civil engineering is one of the oldest types of engineering. Basically, the first time a human cut down a tree to cross a river or build a house, civil engineering was born. Civil engineers design, build, and maintain bridges, dams, roads, subways, water treatment plants, and sewage systems, airports, and other facilities we need to operate our society.
All right, it's becoming clear, but what do you design?
What I love and what I currently do now is traffic engineering, which is a form of transportation engineering. I don't design the roads themselves. I focus on how to use traffic control devices to manage the flow of vehicles, cyclists, and pedestrians, and how to time the signals to keep people moving safely and efficiently on roads and through intersections.
Okay, that sounds pretty cool, but I'm hoping understanding transportation engineering will help me solve a problem back home. Can you show me more about what you do?
Yes, let's go back to my office and I'll show you a problem intersection I worked on to help keep traffic running smoothly and people safe.
That sounds great. Erin showed me how she creates intersections on her computer to analyze the traffic flow. She let me build my own intersection in a program called Synchro.
So now we have what's called the geometrics of the intersection ready. So now we can input volumes. So that's what these numbers are that you see here. So you see these numbers?
Yeah.
We're gonna input those numbers into this program.
Let's make this a big intersection.
You can do the biggest intersection you can possibly do.
And this one.
See how many right turns there are now?
That's a lot of right turns.
It's a lot of right turns.
Have you designed an intersection this big?
No. We typically do not have intersections this big. This would be a bit of a challenge.
How many right turns do you have here?
I put 8.
Okay. Where do they go? There's 2 lanes. So there. And then scroll all the way down and give it the number 8. There you go. Now they have a place to go.
This is pretty good.
A for creativity, a D for safety.
Erin took me to the same intersection we were modeling in her office. She showed me the cabinet where the computer brains of the signal is kept. She also told me a lot about how the signal is installed in the ground and how it solves traffic problems at the intersection.
This is the inside of a signal cabinet. See all the lights flashing on them? It's taking information and it's sending that information into the brains of the controller back here. And they go out to the signal heads there. And then this is a big box of wire. So we go from the wires from there all the way to here. And then they come into our signal pole here. They run up the pole all the way to the top, and then they go all the way over.
Wow, that was really cool. I have a much better idea of what you do now. Where did you learn all this?
I'm originally from Plano, Texas, and I went to school at the University of Alabama, where I earned my bachelor's degree in civil engineering. I'm a licensed professional engineer, which means I have the initials PE after my name. That stands for professional engineer. To qualify for my license, I had to earn my bachelor's degree, complete 4 years of practical work experience, and then I had to pass a challenging 8-hour test. Once an engineer earns their license, they can continue to grow in their career, tackle more challenging projects, and help newer engineers. Today, I'm licensed to work in 3 states, Kansas, Missouri, and Texas. That means I know the rules and laws specific to civil engineering in those states. Each state is a little different.
I bet those are a lot of rules, but it makes sense there'd be a lot for engineers to learn.
Yes, there's a lot to learn, and there's been a lot of hard work to get to this point. And there's a lot to know to be a good engineer. You should stay curious and be passionate about problem solving. But that makes sense, right? I mean, you want the people who design your homes, buildings, and roads to know how to do it the best way possible, right? Best practices, materials, and technologies are always improving. So professional engineers take continuing education classes every year to keep up with what's new. It's important we do this because when we put our professional engineering seal on a project, we are authorizing that the work is safe for the public. We stake our professional reputation and people's lives on the work we do.
If I want to become an engineer now, what can I do to prepare?
I suggest you do anything and everything you can do to practice being creative.
Yeah, I think I can do that.
I personally love solving puzzles and doing arts and crafts, and I highly recommend that you get used to being curious, asking lots of questions, and coming up with creative ideas. Every day, I have to think of new and different ways to do things. There isn't usually one simple answer to solving problems in a challenging intersection or segment of roadway.
What else should I do? I bet engineers need to like math and science a lot, right?
Yes, they have to take a ton of math and science courses, and they need to do well in them. Some high schools offer basic engineering classes, so take those if they're available to you. Also, try to job shadow or do a summer internship so you can get exposure to the field and understand what you want to do.
Erin, thank you so much for meeting with us today. I had no idea so much went into managing the flow of traffic and keeping bikes, pedestrians, and cars safe. I also never knew there were so many different types of engineers.
Yes. Every February, many companies also celebrate Engineers Week. Olsson visits classrooms to do fun activities and teach students about the importance of engineering. You can visit the Discover Engineering website to get started now and learn more about a career in engineering.
I'll do that. Erin has inspired me to come up with the perfect solution for the problem with my game. I'll go do some engineering to fix it right now. While I do that, I recommend you visit HirePaths.com to learn more about civil engineering and other high-demand careers in Kansas. Until next time, this is Owen signing off for Cool Careers in Overland Park. Have a great day. I'm gonna go fix my game now.
Good luck.
All right, I'm pretty sure I think I know what to do now. All right, we're gonna put a few traffic lights. All right, I'm pretty sure this will work. Go! I think I did it.
Yeah!
I did it! What else should I do? Engineers need a lot, like them a lot.
Yes, there's a lot to learn, but, and it's been a, yep, good. I was gonna say, but it's been a long journey, that's not it.
Traffic right then, too.
Yeah, we're gonna go with that was what distracted me. Yes, let's go back to my office and I can show you a problem intersection I worked on and how I was able to solve it to help everyone have a better, I don't know. What was the line again?